I was wondering, if she could keep on, because the force has got a lot of power, and it makes me feel like it makes me feel like.
Then you can start making it rain like you're at Lululemon on a Tuesday. How do you sell to people that you can't go in and meet them?
He is a video mastery genius.
Your prospects, they don't have a short attention span. I hear you making that excuse all the time. The reality is, their attention span's perfect. Your stories just suck. Stories are the glue that binds your prospects' attention into your solution. Now is your defining moment. Like, you've trained for this moment your entire life without even knowing it. Let's talk about the number one limiting belief that people have before they get started with video. You know, when I'm working with people, they're like, I don't like how I look on camera. Oh, really? Guess what? Neither do I. I didn't have a nose job. I'm going through skin cancer right now. With LinkedIn's new lead gen forms and video ads, you can target your perfect decision maker by location, industry, title. Plus, with the right offer, you can generate high quality leads at scale. And the video ads allow you to retarget visitors for 365 days. Attention span is a covert signal for buyer's interest. And this little trick in just 30 days generated $350,000 in new business. That's how it's done. Boom! Damn, that Todd, he's on the ball.
At the time, it was breakthrough, right? No one had ever heard of using video in the sales process,
right?
You've now optimized your engagement 5 times. Don't shrink from this moment. When other people start slowing down and they sit on their couch and they're taking bong hits watching Netflix, now is your time to speed up and to get the work that you need done. And when I added pricing to our website, it was a game changer for my business.
I'm going to talk about which videos you should invest real money in and the other videos that you should do on the cheap.
Hello, everyone, and welcome. I am Anna Bryce, and I am the VP of Programming at the AMA Phoenix. We are really thrilled to have everybody here. And we are even more thrilled to have Todd Hartley back to speak with us. I believe this might be our third time over the years, and we just love Todd. So thank you, Todd, for being here with us. And all of us at the AMA were thrilled to have you come back. And we think you are the perfect person to start our AMA year this year. So thank you. And before we get started, I'm just going to quickly do some housekeeping things. We want to thank our sponsors. Again, without them, we couldn't do what we do. And I particularly today would like to thank Taylor Wellman from Financial Potion, who hosts us for all of our webinars. So if you ever need to get in touch with Taylor, please, you can reach out to me. You have my email address and I can connect you. But we are thrilled that Taylor continues to host us this year, and at least until we get back to live events. So thank you, Taylor, and thank you to our sponsors. And then last, we just would like to thank our board members. We have a great team who works really hard, and what we have here and every month is because of each and every one of our board members. So we do thank them. And I just want to get right into introducing Todd. So as I mentioned, Todd Hartley is back with us today, and he is starting our year. Todd Hartley is the CEO and founder of WireBuzz. And if you were here when we did the video, video is his specialty, as is remote selling and sales optimization. And we're lucky to have him today because right after he's done, not necessarily jumping in the car and leaving, but he will be leaving to do, you know, his Tony Robbins tour that he has been on for quite a while. So we are thankful that he's able to take this hour with us. And I hear a book is coming, so I look forward to when we get the news that his book is out and we can let everybody know. So Todd, welcome and thank you for joining us.
For the audience, if you wouldn't mind putting on your camera, it would just be so rewarding for me to be able to engage with you and to see your smiles. It would mean the world to me. Right on. Thank you, Trevor. So I'm going to get us started. Today, I'm going to be talking with you about getting comfortable on camera and really the essentials for rocking your mojo on camera in 2022. A little bit about me. I'm one of Tony Robbins' business mastery faculty speakers. I'm actually right after this. This is the last thing I'm doing. I've got all my props here in a bag, and I'm going to lead a training for Tony Robbins for 100 minutes on the biggest stage in the entire world. But before I do that, I love to pay it where it all got started, right here on the AMA stage, and be able to spend some time with you guys. Here's the last event I did for Tony. This is footage that I filmed with my phone while they were miking me up and before I spoke in front of 12,000 people.
Oh,
Tony just left me this perfect audience, and all I'm probably going to do is screw up all that amazing energy.
Looks like one of our events, right?
Yeah, no doubt. That is AMA at its best. And so I own an agency here in the Valley called WireBuzz. We're an ROI-focused video marketing and sales optimization agency. I say ROI focused because I really don't want to do this unless we're converting for ROI. Like, that for me is the most exciting part. I grew up in LA. I want nothing to do with an Academy Award. I want to do revenue with people and help them grow their business, because that totally fires me up. Here are some of my clients, companies like MD Anderson and Home Depot and AAA and major universities like my alma mater, the great University of Arizona, and celebrities like Justin Timberlake and, of course, Tony Robbins. But I want to be a responsible communicator today. And a responsible communicator owns not only what comes out of their mouth, but how it is processed, received, retained, and even shared. So if I'm a responsible communicator, if you could do me a favor, if it clicks for you in your head, click it out for me like the audience does for me at a big event. Everybody practice clicking it out. Let's click it out. Yes. Thank you very much. We're going to click it out. And that's how you're going to communicate to me that you know that it makes sense for you. And that allows me to go forward in the material. Now, McKinsey and Company released a study that I think just about changes everything for business. And it's important if we're going to spend time together that I break it down for you, because 75% of B2B decision makers prefer remote human interactions over in-person sales. Why? Well, I'll add one that isn't in the study, but I think it's the most obvious. Salespeople suck, right? And interacting with salespeople sucks. But here's what McKinsey and Company says. They said that the reason is ease of scheduling, savings on travel expenses. Like, how many of us over the years have flown across the country for one meeting for 1 hour and then flew back home? Ease of travel, saving, safety. And I'll add this one right here. Overall, greater productivity. Like, we can drop in and have a meeting and Zoom in with people and be gonzo after that meeting. And that about changes preference of buyers. And when buyer preference changes, a lot happens. The way we sell changes, the way we engage changes. I'm going to be talking with you about that. And I'm going to prepare you to sell más rápido in this new world using the power of video. Now, LinkedIn in their state of business report found that 70% of buyers want to continue working remotely half or more of the time in the future. This brings me to a topic that I call a COVID gain. Like, we've lived through 2 years of all these things that are horrible about COVID. I don't even need to rattle them off. Loss of loved ones, you know, being sick. I'm 2 weeks from COVID. I gave it to my dad, who's going through chemo of lung cancer. And so I understand the heartache part of it. And then somewhere in all of this is what I like to call a COVID gain. And we ain't giving those gains back. That's like, are you getting up early and walking with your spouse in the morning? Are you exercising more because you're not sitting in traffic? Are you doing things like having a nap in the middle of the day? So many of you, I know you are. Some of us prefer not to wear dry cleaning clothes, right? And instead, we're wearing business up here and pajamas down below. It is a COVID gain. But if you're going to sell to people that aren't in the office, you can't walk in, press flesh, go and meet them. The rules have changed, which means your tactics need to also. We're going to spend time on that because we aren't, and buyers aren't going to give up our COVID gains. In fact, I've got a bootcamp starting January 26th where I'm going to teach you how to get comfortable on camera, how to rock your mojo, how to use the power of video. And we're going to touch on it a little bit today. But if you want to learn about that, and it's 5 weeks with me and I review your videos and I give you feedback on how you can make those videos better for your business, toddhartley.com/start is where you get started and learn more.
Todd Hartley is a total genius. I attended one of his training sessions. Within 24 hours, applied his strategy and immediately landed a six-figure deal.
People do this all the time. Because once you understand how to use video inside of your business, you can start closing deals at freakish rates. And that's part of the fun. So I want to talk to you about a little bit more about COVID gains, because 65% of workers say that they'll take a pay cut to never go back into the office. So if you're thinking about going back into the office to sell to people, offices are empty. I've got a marketing agency. And you know what? I used to have a big, beautiful, like New York, Manhattan-looking agency in the heart of Scottsdale, Arizona. And you know what it is now? It's me in this little executive suite because everybody in my agency is working from home in their PJs. So our tactics are changing. 70% of B2B decision makers, people we're all trying to sell to, say that they don't, they're comfortable and open to making new remote purchases over $50,000. And 27% would spend over $500,000. So the game is changing. I'm going to teach you a little bit about my framework. This is the framework that I created. It's a five-zone framework for using video inside of your business. The reason I created it is every single time I heard a video marketing expert talk about video, they're really only talking about one zone. They're really only teaching people about one dimension, but video is the most powerful tool in the business world for convincing and converting. It's multidimensional. It is not just social media. And the faster we accept that, realize that buyers are going to be reviewing us online, the faster we make the transition to a full funnel on our website and our salespeople using video from their phone, creating it to impact the deal flows. And I'll show you quickly. The first part is marketing, all marketing activities. Like raise your hand if you wouldn't mind. And for those of you who don't have your camera on, let me just shame on you. But for the rest of you, raise your hand if you work at a company and you've got people that have marketing responsibilities and other people that have sales responsibilities. Okay. Raise your hand if you're have a smaller company and you assume both responsibilities. All right, beautiful. Now I'm going to talk your language. I appreciate it. This left part, marketing, that's the left part of your brain. The right part is your sales brain or your customer support brain. And as we do this, zone one is discovery. This is how people find you. They find you when you put videos out on social media. Maybe you run ads. Maybe you do a webinar. That right there is zone one. But the responsibility in zone one is to not just pique their interest. You've got to do more than that. You've got to move people from zone one down into zone two. So you got to move them from where they discover you to your website where they can learn more about you. If that makes sense, snap it out for me. Beautiful. Kimberly, I love that. Can we all just see what Kimberly like rocked it for a moment? Took it up another level. Right on, Kimberly. All right. So if that makes sense, the job is not just zone one. You've got to pique their interest, but you've got to move them to your website where they go down a rabbit hole journey, which is an effortless, on-demand buying experience where they learn about you and they can learn about you without burning any mental calories and reading. They can just kind of go through. So you got to create a rabbit hole journey on your website that's designed for people to learn what they need to learn about your business. And the three types of videos that I'm going to teach you right now while we're together, you're going to be able to use on your website. Sound good? If so, raise your hand so I know it sounds good. Good. I love it. All right, good. I love it. The next zone is your sales and your support. Your salespeople or you as a salesperson could be creating videos that you put in zone one to get discovered. I'm going to teach you about discovery in just a second, but the easiest way to think about zone one is just be helpful. Like put helpful information out there. Like all damn day, people are asking you questions about your business. Well, how do you do that, Nat? I don't understand. And then Nat answers these questions all day long. Burton's no different. He answers questions. Once you're answering questions, supply and demand. If people are demanding it, supply it and put it out in where? Zone one, and then drive them to your website. That's what salespeople and the function will do. And then when people are going through your sales process, if they get confused, you should be like a bloodhound for confusion. Sniff it out. And when people are confused, grab your phone, create a video, answer that for them and send it to them. And you know what you're going to do? Eliminate confusion and inject clarity right there into their brain. Okay. Zone four is all about how you support your clients. The low-hanging fruit. The people that have already know, loved, and trusted you, and the people you're more likely to sell to again. And zone five is all about how you scale your business and train new people by using video. So you train once, and when people, you hire them, you run them through the training that you've created. And now everybody is speaking your language the right way so they can represent you. Does that make sense? Good, good. All right, good. Don't worry, your thumbs will not be calloused by the end of this event, I promise you. So why video? Well, video is the most powerful tool in the business. Well, Andrew doesn't look like he believes me very much. Yeah, Andrew, I'm talking to you, bro. Hey, why video? Like, why is video the most powerful tool? Let me break it down for you. Here we go. We're all really just trying to do three things. And thank you, Andrew, for letting me give you a little business. So the first thing is we want to earn attention. I mean, that's the primary role. Earn attention, transfer knowledge, convert customers, boom, life is good. So when you want to earn attention, people, that's who we're trying to sell to. People are four times more likely to watch video than to read text. And when we want to transfer knowledge from your big, massive brain into your prospect's brain, like this, right into that brain, people are going to retain so much more with video. They retain 95% of the message when they watch it in video, compared to only 10% when they read it in text. Let me break this down. Text sucks. It's asking people to burn too many mental calories to learn about your business. And candidly, they don't really care. They just want to know if you could solve their problems. So if you can transfer your knowledge in video, they'll buy from you at freakish rates, because when it comes time to converting customers, after watching a product or service video, prospects are 85% more likely to buy. Boom! Like, that's how we do it, okay? We earn attention, transfer knowledge, convert them into customers. Everybody is super happy. Now, there are three types of videos. Three, that every business professional in this new world needs to know how to create at a moment's notice. And that means you, because it's so powerful. I'm going to teach you how easy it is to create video. For those of you that want to go deeper with me, I'll get you to the point in the bootcamp where you've polished and perfected yourself so you can rock your mojo every day and impact the deal flow. But let me go through the three types for you. Now, knowledge isn't power anymore. Knowledge is just, you know, knowing something, but execution trumps knowledge every damn day of the week. So I've got to do my best in the limited amount of time to make sure that you can execute, all right? So here we go. There are three types of videos: a teleprompter video, a show and tell video, and a selfie video. And this is my video creation decision tree. Feel free in a few moments to take a screenshot of this or use your phone. This is where everything gets started for me. Before I grab the equipment and create a video, I'm like, all right, what do I need to do? Like, what do I need to accomplish with these people? And then once I figure that out, then I decide what type of three videos do I create. So let's do the first one, a teleprompter video. If you have too much information to rattle off the top of your head in a very specific order, who here works in a highly regulated industry? Okay, good. I knew it. I would have bet everything on it, bro. I would have taken this money right here, this, you know, just some random, sorry, it's Arizona, random cash I've got laying around. I would have bet that you're in a highly regulated industry. And I see Alexis, the two of you are in a highly regulated industry. Then if that's the case, you might want to consider creating a teleprompter video. The next type of video is, if showing something is going to help your prospects better understand, show and tell. So when would I show and tell? When it's confusing. I grew up struggling miserably with multiple learning disabilities. I am no different than anybody you're trying to sell to. If you're trying to sell something that is confusing, which is like everybody in this audience, because it's not your customer's wheelhouse, show and tell all damn day. Put yourself on screen, put your information right here and coach them, because the dual coding theory of education teaches us that when we show and tell, people learn at faster rates. I'm going to teach you how to create a show and tell video. And the final one is the one that every millennial knows how to make at a moment's notice. And that is a selfie video. If you can quickly answer their question off the top of your head and them seeing anything, will not impact their ability to learn or process at a higher level, then grab your phone and create a teleprompter video. If that makes sense, snap it out for me, AMA. Good. Good. I love it. Trevor, I love this style. This went like two snaps, don't burn too much energy down. And that right there is efficient, my friend. And I love it. All right. So here we go. We're going to create a selfie video. Yes, right here, all of us, if you let me. But I want to give you the most common limiting beliefs that keep people from using video. All right. The number one limiting belief is, yo, I don't like how I look on camera. All right. And the truth is, none of us really do. Like, even supermodels are seeing their therapist over this topic. And so everybody struggles with this issue. And the sooner we get out of our own way so we could start serving people, the better off we're going to be and the better off the lives that we get to impact are. let me give you a Todd example. I got my haircut today. I'm like all clean shaven and ready to stand on a stage in front of Tony Robbins' 10,000 audience people. And so like vanity right here, like I got my outfit picked out for weeks. Well, when Tony Robbins booked me for the first time at the very beginning of the pandemic, March 2020, to come train all of his 74 businesses. Now there's like 108 businesses, but to train each of his businesses on how to sell remotely from the safety of their home. I booked 7 events through the whole summer of 2020. And then what happened in April of 2020, all of our doctor's offices opened up again. And I went and saw my dermatologist, and as a good 30-year resident of the Valley of the Sun, sure enough, I had skin cancer here and here. And when the dermatologist opened up, she said, dude, we're going to have surgery all over your face. And we're going to have 3 surgeries on 2 spots. Both spots need 3 surgeries. It's going to take 12 weeks. And good news, we're going to be able to reconstruct your nose. In my brain, I was like, no, you don't understand. I just booked Tony Robbins all summer. I'm going to train all of his companies, 1,500 people at a time, to use video. I'm going to have to delay this. So I went home and I told my wife. And this is what happens when you're married. God bless you. But what happened to me is my wife got to me, talked sense into me. And I was like, yeah, well, I'm going to put off the surgery and then do the Tony trainings. And then she's like, no, you aren't. And I go, oh, well, then I'll delay Tony and I'll get this. And she's not going to delay Tony. And I'm like, I'm not going to do all these Tony trainings looking like Bozo the Clown. And she said, dude, let me get this straight. Are you telling me that your vanity, your desire, willingness, and need to look like a friggin' supermodel is going to outweigh your willingness to get out there and serve people at the moment in your career that's the most impactful? And I was like, oh yeah, that's exactly what I'm saying. And she said, no, dude, you're getting out there. So here's how I was introduced to all of Tony Robbins's companies. Okay. I did all of my trainings like this. Let me tell you what happened. As soon as I got out of my way and I started serving them, just like you'll experience, boom, a love connection happened. They identified that I didn't care about how I looked and my primary focus was serving them. And before I knew it, they loved me. Exactly what's going to happen to you when you get out of your own way and you start caring for people. The next limiting belief is I don't have an expensive camera. Guess what? You don't need one. I say use what you got because what you got is pretty damn good. Everybody reach for your phone. Let me see your phone. Boom, bounce, bow, wow, beautiful. Everybody's got their phone. Look at that. Nobody had to get out of their chair. Jane, do you have your phone nearby? You do? And Lynn, what about you? Do you have your phone nearby? Good. Are you telling me that not a single person had to walk on the other side of the room? I mean, this is just flat out remarkable. The reality is we've all got our phone within arm's length. And so do every one of our clients. And that's why for text messages, 98% of text messages are open, 98% of them within 2 minutes. The sooner we start creating videos and communicate to our prospect in their phone, the faster we go from a 20% email open rate to 5 times that with text message at 98%. And we start engaging people at a much higher level. Use what you got. What you got is really damn good. I'm going to give you a cell phone tutorial and I'm going to walk you through this. Everybody, first thing, grab your phone, lift it up like you're about to film yourself. Okay. I want to see you film yourself like you would if I wasn't here. Good, good, good. All right. My friend, Jane Peters, you better put your camera on, girl. And then, what I want is everybody like this. This is the Kung Fu grip. Let me see your Kung Fu grip right here. Kung Fu grip, thumb at the top. Why thumb at the top? Because you're going to do this. Start, stop, record, start, stop, right? Kung Fu grip. And the first piece here is your camera should be at eye level. So everybody lift up your camera. Boom. Let me see it. Boom. Yell it out. Upset your neighbors. Boom. And once you do that, that's the way it should be each and every time. It should be at eye level. Why? Because that's how you look your best. In fact, nobody wants, don't film up at yourself or down at yourself. Nobody likes that angle except your ear, nose, and throat doctor. They're the only ones that like this angle. Cut that out. Nobody wants to look up your nose when you're doing your videos. So every time at eye level, the next thing I want you to do is your light should be in front of you, not behind you. My lights are right here. See my hands? You can see they're right here. People like Jane and Joe and Todd and Nancy and Trevor. Oh, and Burton, excuse me. The really smart ones, the glasses wearers like Evelyn. When we put our lens, our camera light right in front of us, we get rings. So I want you to offset to the outsides, because this is just for people who are the smart ones that wear the glasses, put offside, okay? And you'll be great. And you won't get a reflection. But I also want you to realize that your light should be in front of you, not behind. So if you have a big, amazing view, like right outside my window, I have an amazing view of the McDowell Mountains. I'm not showing you, not because I'm modest. I'd love to show you, but these lenses are not good enough to be able to adjust for God's light. Okay. Instead, limit the background and only put the light in front of you, and the cameras will be beautiful. All right. If that makes sense, snap it out for me. Great job, everybody. You had no idea you were going to be burning calories in this session. This is good. All right. The next one is I want you to make eye contact with the lens and not the screen. Everybody, kung fu grip, give me a boom, point to where your camera is. Point to that camera. Good. Thank you, Trevor. Thank you, Lynn. All right. Now, everybody can lower your arms. I don't want anybody to cramp out. I know we still got a long way to go. But what I want you to do is don't do what other people do. Don't look at yourself on the screen. Because what people do is they do this. And then they get themselves here. And then they're like, wait a minute, my face looks so much better when I lift up my eyes and my eyebrows, get my eyebrows just right. And then warm up those cheeks. And they get their cheeks. And then they're like, just about to start recording. And they're like, but wait, if only my lips were a little more plumper. And then they go like this. And then they start recording. And you know what they do next? They can't think of anything up here. And then they tell me that they can't say anything smart, because all of their brain power CPU is being processed on making their face look perfect. And the reality is nobody cares. We just want your information. We want to love you. We want to learn from you. So when you grab this, don't look at yourself on the screen. Just engage. The biggest thing is perfection is not the goal. Connection is. Connect with the lens. And when you do that, it'll resonate in people's chest. And before you know it, just like you do when you get in front of people in the old world, when you get in front of them and you develop that relationship, when you start connecting with the lens, magic happens and they identify with you. So make sure you don't make that mistake. Let's get to the next one. I want you to add massive freaking value every time you get on camera, because if you don't add value, people won't watch it. And if they don't watch your first video, they won't watch your second or your third. But if you add so much value every time, values like answering questions and being helpful, being that sage that you already are. If you give people helpful advice, they will always watch your videos and they will share it. And not only that, they will start marketing on your behalf, AMA. So when they're sitting down with somebody or they're in a conversation and they're like, hey, you know, I'm trying to do XYZ. People are like, you should talk with Sharon Elliott. I mean, she's amazing. Have you seen her videos? So share value. And it'll resonate with people and go a long way. The next thing is show willingness to be helpful. Like each and every one of you, if you were in person, you'd be that Sherpa that you are every day. You'd be that trusted advisor, the one that holds the torch for your clients and guides them through their confusion. Joe knows I'm right. He's nodding his head. What I want you to do is show a willingness to be that same beautiful person that you are in person, but do it in your videos and advise and guide, and it'll resonate with people. Next, know where it's going to be posted. All right, let's do it. LinkedIn, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram. There's some ways to fudge it, but wherever you're going to post your video, know in advance what environment you want to dominate. And when you do that, you'll know which way the video should be. Okay? Beautiful. Good. The next thing is, I want you to frame yourself up appropriately. Like, this is an important part because a lot of people leave all this space above their head. Like, they need daylight or something. Like, they're a hunting target and they got to put themselves right in the center to get a good hunt. Like, they're going to hang themselves above their couch so they can watch more Netflix. Don't do that. Instead, just leave a little bit of daylight above your head. I want you to realize that each and every one of you are a masterpiece and you deserve to be framed up appropriately. Let's adjust all of our cameras right now on Zoom. See what I've got? Just a little bit of daylight. My hair's fluffy. Just a little bit of daylight right up here, right? Even when I zoom in and I punch in, boom, just a little bit of daylight. I'm prepared for you. And so good. Everybody just updated themselves. And Anna, you've got your hunting target. Okay, so perfect. That's the way I want you. I want you to be a masterpiece. Think about this. Would Leonardo da Vinci be like one of the greatest artists if he framed Mona Lisa up like this? Would this $1,000 fake bill be worth as much if the dude's head was down here? Like, no, not at all. So let's just frame ourselves up like the masterpiece that we are. And your videos, by the way, should not look like mugshots. So don't push yourself up against the wall because that is creepy. Instead, the human eye craves depth. Look at that. This young lady, she's got depth, a nice clean background, and party people, you know who you are. Get rid of that bong in the background. It's not necessary. It's going to do more harm than good. Get rid of anything in the background. Like, I'm a messy eater. I had lunch here today on that desk. But before I did this event, I cleaned that up because you don't need to know what kind of a disastrous eater I am. Clean up your work environment, use depth. And like I've got here, right? And if you've got a wall behind you, it's okay. Angle off a little bit. Joe did a really good job. He got himself a screen. Like, you, anybody could get a screen off of Amazon if you don't have a presentable workplace. There's 1,000 ways to do it. You can also grab your phone, go outside, enjoy some of this Arizona weather before third degree burn weather. This would be a good time to also create videos outside. It's beautiful out there. All right, good. Create a teleprompter video. Before I go, does everybody understand the fundamentals? If so, snap it out. Good. Thank you, Taylor. Thank you, Karen. Love the spirit. Even Andrew's into it now. I love it. Right on, brother. Right on. All right. So now I'm going to teach all of you to create a teleprompter video, and I'm going to show you which one you can use. But you create a teleprompter video when you have too much information to rattle off the top of your head. I confided in you one of my biggest secrets, that I struggled with attention disorders for a very long time and dyslexia. If I'm dealing with stats, yo, I'm probably not going to rattle it off the top of my head. I'm probably going to put it in a teleprompter and I'm going to organize myself and knock it down. So let's get into this. Tony Robbins is top national speaker, KK. Carissa Cuches comes on stage and warms up the audience before Tony does. That's KK way back in the distance. KK went through this training, and right after
teleprompter video,
Tony asked her to create videos for the comeback challenge. There were 1 million people live in the audience, and she had all these details that he needed her to communicate. KK went through this training. Here's what she had to say about the training you're about to go through. Here's KK.
A teleprompter video is life changing, especially for the comeback challenge. We had so many things to record, and I was like, wait a minute, I have a screenshot of what Todd suggested for us. So I want to say thank you.
Ah, you kidding? Thank you. Let's do this for everybody in the crowd. So the most common limiting belief that people have that revolves around a teleprompter is, I don't want anyone to think that I'm not smart. Very common, right? I've gone through this for like a split second. But here's how you do it. You put the information in teleprompter. Here's the teleprompter that I use. It's called Teleprompter for Video. This is just for iPhones, Droid users. I'll share yours next. Please know, everybody, that this is $12. This is a tool for your phone. And I'm going to show you how to optimize it. By the way, do you see that name? Teleprompter for video. Clearly, marketers, this was not a name created by somebody from the AMA. Like, that's a crap name, teleprompter for video, and you know it. They could have came up with something better. A marketer in a room in an hour and a six pack could have came up with 1,000 things better than that. But let me show you how to use it. So do you notice that we're all going blind? Like, if you're going blind, I'm going blind. I can barely see looking at my devices. So the first natural instinct is to put the text all over the screen so you can read. Don't do that. Why? Because when people read a teleprompter, have you guys ever seen this before? You're watching something. By the way, I'm totally bipartisan. You're watching Anderson Cooper or Tucker Carlson. Now I got everybody. Okay, good. So when you're watching the news and the person is doing this and you're like, well, I mean, this guy apparently is supposed to be an expert, but I can tell by his eyes, he's reading. This dude's not an expert. He's an imposter, right? We all do this. What I want you to do is fool people. When you use a teleprompter, the trick is for them to not know you're using a teleprompter. The trick is for you to not have the text be massive across your screen, even if you're going friggin' blind. The trick is to smush the text as close to the camera as possible and be a disciplined reader, and I'll teach you that right now. Here we go. So you can see, I have the text right here, smushed up against the camera. Okay. Below at the bottom, there's a speed. I'm like a 5. You can go up to 100 if you want. If you're a speed reader, I'm a 5. The next thing is you can change where the text goes in the settings. And I only want you to read the parts that are like in horizontal plane of the camera. Because if you go too high up or too low or too left or too right, people will know you're reading. Okay, so that's the trick. And the other trick is I want you to put it inside of a tripod. I'm packed for Tony Robbins. My tripod is not here, though I'm so glad that I did this because I realized I forgot some of my props. And so I recommend you put this in a tripod, boom. Because if you're holding this and you've had 7 cups of coffee today like me, there's no way you're going to hold this little script and be able to drill it like a rock star that you are. So put it into a little teleprompter, and I'll give you a recommendation in a few moments. Lock it in there and then look into the camera and go. And when I say go, I just looked at my watch and it told me that I am running late. Here is the Droid one. It's called Nano Teleprompter. It is $399. Droid users, big savings. Pass that on to your customers, that saving. And then here is the Light Ring that I highly recommend all of you get. It is $30. If you have glasses and you're one of the smart ones like Nancy, get yourself 2 of these. Put one in front of you. Don't turn the light on. Get the second one. Put it off at a 45-degree angle and turn that light on. But free your hands up, because when you talk and you do this, you're going to be amazing. All right. Speaking of amazing, let me in the closing minute or so tell you about the third type of video, a show and tell video. When do you do this? When showing something is going to help people better understand. Show and tell all damn day long, because it's not about you. It's about your audience. So if it's easier for somebody to learn and it clicks in their head, show it to them. I'll train you right now. I put my big, beautiful mug and my slides on camera like this. My slides, it could be a PowerPoint, it could be a keynote, it could be your website. It shouldn't be boring text, because it's boring. And we're marketers and we're in the attention business. And the more we command attention and make things beautiful and interesting, the better off we will be. Thank you, Nat. So our job is to always make it look interesting. And so what I want you to do is I'm going to give you 20 seconds. I'm going to teach you how to do this. I use a tool called Vidyard, vidyard.com. Here's 20 seconds of me creating a show and tell video. Here we go. First, click on the Vidyard app. Then select your slides of your proposal that you want to display on the screen. Hit record. Wave to your prospect, go through the material, and then when you're done, trim the edges, enter your prospect's name, click send, and they've got your proposal video.
They got it.
So look, do that every time you submit a proposal. Every single time for the rest of your career, you ask somebody for money. Anytime somebody's confused, red frickin' flag, red flag. You know what you should be doing? You're like, oh, I don't know. They didn't seem to understand what I was talking about on that Zoom call. Red flag, a responsible communicator, which you are, identifies the confusion and you control how you submit that information back to them. You put your face on camera, you teach them and you move them through because you already know that people are going to learn when they see it visually. Vidyard.com is the tool. Here are your three types of videos, the show and tell, the teleprompter, and also the selfie video, and big suspense. Congratulations, everybody. You have now been trained on the three types of DIY, do-it-yourself videos that everybody needs to know.
If Todd you want to get Hartley on is video. A total genius.
Sorry, Kim.
I attended this one of his training Kim. Sessions.
By the way, you guys, if you want to get comfortable on video, you want somebody to coach you how to rock your mojo and to create these different types of videos and give you feedback each and every time. So those videos are, like you are, amazing. ToddHartley.com/start is where you get going. January 26th is when this kicks off. It's 1 hour every week, first thing in the morning with me. By the way, I'm happy to take questions. I'm just incredibly, incredibly honored to have started my career on the AMA stage and get to do this with all of you before I take off and get to do my big event. But I'm happy to take questions in the remaining time, everyone.
Excellent. Well, thank you so very much. That was so much information. And I do have a couple of questions here. One of the questions that first came in was, how much of your personal self should you show on video versus your professional brand? So for your example, it's how much of BuzzWired versus Tom would you, you know, Todd, would yep. you show on social media?
Yeah, I think that's a great question. At the beginning, it should mostly be supply and demand. You supply what your prospects are typically demanding. These are the common questions that come up on a regular basis. Turn yourself into a magnet that attracts leads, and people will see you for what you really are, a guru in your space, a thought leader, somebody that's knowledgeable that can help them solve their problems. Then, as people start learning about you, open up a little more. So like, I look at it like I'm backing out of my primary topic and I'm introducing to them to stuff that's also going on in my life. But like you, yes, you, I have political thoughts. I do, but I don't share them with people because it's not appropriate. Neither is going out partying or saying anything that is offensive or dropping F-bombs. So this doesn't really look like, with exception to a couple of people, and you know who you are, a group that is really offensive to too many people. And I'm just joking about that. Like, this feels like you guys could all navigate that relatively easily. But I would recommend very little of your personal life at the beginning until the audience is starting to demand it. Like, I don't film in my house, right? I don't show my car. Like, I've never once, though I've thought about it, laid across the hood of my car. Okay. But I would recommend you just keep it professional. And in each and every industry, and I literally believe this, there is a spot for you. There's a spot for another thought leader. There's a spot for another guru. Your way of looking at your industry is going to be completely different than other people because you have unique insights and experiences over your career. And this is an experienced group, which means you've got wisdom to share. So please don't hesitate to share that wisdom because the people that get hired today, they're not the ones with the longest Rolodex or the longest resume. And I know this is a group that understands Rolodexes, but this is the person that gets hired today is the one that is best known. Like, I'm probably, and it pains me to say this, I'm probably not the best marketer in the world. All right, cat's out of the bag. I'm probably not. But my job as a marketer is to become one of the best known. And so it is for you too. And that starts when you put your big, beautiful face on camera and you get out of your way and you serve people.
Well, thank you for that, Todd. So next question is, should you worry about editing your videos before posting them? And do you have good recommendations for consumer-friendly editing softwares for a PC and Android user?
So the first part is, nobody's expecting Steven Spielberg. Like when you post a video, they're not going to be like, oh, she didn't even have a smoke machine, that Karen, right? Nobody's going to do that. Instead, just realize that if you're just helpful and you're just supplying information, it's good. And with your phone, you can trim the edges. What's the edges? It's this. Now you can trim that part off. And, you know, so now you're just looking at the camera. So I recommend, like a very well-trained Olympic gymnast, when you're done, stick your landing. Boom. Look at the camera for a good two count. Then when you go to trim, there's all this space for you to remove that part off. Then for, PCs come with video editing, and all you have to do is go on to YouTube. And just so we're all on the same page, because it took me 45 minutes to realize that my mom was typing in U, the letter U, in tube. And I couldn't figure out why she couldn't get there. And I had zits for days. But you can just go on YouTube and search up a how to edit with the editing software that's free inside of your device. And within 30 minutes, you're going to be an editor that can put your name on the bottom. Okay. And do some basic things. But the reality is nobody's expecting that of you. Later on, as you start to demonstrate that you're ready for prime time and you want to go up the next level, you can always add that into your skill set.
So if someone's ready to add that into their skill set, perhaps they did multiple takes, there's some flubs and mess ups. What do you think about posting bloopers?
Okay, Taylor, I love it. By the way, if you have a brand that is, you're trying to grow the brand, I recommend professional videos. Like if your brand is about quality and so on, then professional videos has a really important role. But if you're just answering questions, I look at that as perishable videos that you can film on your own. And the videos on your website should really be non-perishable. They're going to last 3 to 5 years. And there are very good video creators inside AMA that you guys all know that would be able to serve you, okay? The website's where your investment goes. Social media is not where it goes. You can create those on your own. And so, Taylor, what was the next question? Sorry.
Bloopers.
What do you think bloopers. About bloopers and posting those bloopers?
You guys, I'm a co-survivor of a breast cancer patient. And I'm on the board of the American Society of Breast Surgeons, and I go in non-pandemic years to every medical cancer oncology conference throughout the year. And the number one thing that the medical community comes up and talks to me about are my blooper videos. Because every time I go to one of these events, I drop a blooper video like 2 days before. And it warms and humanizes me. And they're like, okay, so he's not perfect. You know, he screws up too. And people come up and they're like laughing already, like they're in the inside joke. Use it. My issue is I've been doing this so long, I don't even react when I flub. I don't do like the, oh, so my bloopers aren't that good anymore. But I highly recommend trim them up or find somebody that can edit them for you. And maybe once a month, have fun. Because people relate to people they can have a good time with, and that people that aren't so uptight.
Excellent. Thank you for that. So don't be afraid to show your mess ups. And so the next question is, how does email interface with video, and what do you lead with? Would you always include a video with your email, and what are some tools and suggestions you have around that?
I love this question. I don't know if I'm going to be able to explain it in 3 minutes. I'm such a nerd for it. I train it in my trainings, but I had a very large multi-million-dollar, $100-300 million company come and hire me to train their entire international sales team. And I trained them on how to use video in their email. And they went from a 20% open rate, which is industry standard. Right. And it sucks. Everybody's got it. So don't take any offense. But she's not good enough. And they went from a 20% to a 69.5% open rate and a 3x increase on their click-through rate. Really, you need to think it's mostly about psychology. Because in psychology, there are things that grab your eye that you value over other things that should be in that title. What's the most important word in that title? Video. Why? Because each and every one of us were super lazy. And if we get a word video in the subject and it catches our eye with like four other things that I'll train you on, mm-hmm. you know what it does? It's like somebody sending you a Kit Kat bar in the middle of your day. You get to take a break, sit at your desk and watch a video, and people do it. They're more likely to do it because it's easy. It's like the same reason that people spend on average 2 hours a day watching Netflix. On average, 700 million people worldwide spend 2 hours a day watching Netflix. Not because we have short attention spans. It's not true. We have long attention spans for things we're interested in. So smart marketers know how to make their email interesting. And I look forward to training you on that.
Great. Excellent. I know we put that link in the chat box a few times. If you want to save that link and save the chat box, go ahead and click on those three dots you see right to the bottom before you put a post, and then you can save that chat to your computer. So everyone, just thank you again for Todd. Great. This was amazing and a wealth of information.
Thank you, Todd, once again. It really was tremendous information. And again, hopefully this helps you feel more comfortable getting yourself on video, because we all have to deal with it, you know, from here on in. And it's a good way to get a different mix of videos, because you definitely need high production, but if you're going to be putting some things on social media, pull out your camera, pull out your phone, and get it done and get more engagement and get people to see you, the person. I think that's a big part of it, is we're seeing people, actual people, and it becomes relatable. So Todd, thank you once again, and good luck with your tour that you're going to be leaving on. And we look forward to hearing about when your book is out. So definitely, you know, text me and let me know when that does happen. And then I would like to just quickly, our next event, we're not going to have another event in January, but we will have exactly a month from now. So February 10th, which is a Thursday, 3 o'clock to 5 o'clock, Chris Sietzema will be back, and he's going to be teaching us preparing for life without cookies, what marketers need to know. So please join us for that. You know, be on the lookout for emails from us, and we would love to see you there. And that's really it. Again, we thank our sponsors. Taylor, thank you for hosting once again. And if anybody needs to get in touch with Taylor, she is, her company is Financial Potion, or please feel free to email me and I will connect you. And lastly, we thank our board once again, because it's a bunch of hardworking people and a great group of people, and we couldn't get this done without them. Everybody, thank you for joining us, and I hope to see you again in a month on February 10th. Chris Sietzema, he's a really terrific speaker, and we are talking about something we all as marketers need to know. Thank you, and have a great rest of your day.